We have just entered the beautiful month of Elul, a month of love, a month of rachamim, a month of ani ledoidi v'doidi li. And as we prepare for the yamim noraim, as we spend this month introspecting and looking at how we can change, what we can take on and what we can let go of, we want to know what it is that is driving that which we do. Because when we want to make real and lasting changes, those changes need to be made at the root. If we have a tree and the tree is growing yellow leaves, it's not going to help to take green paint and to paint those leaves, because the root keeps on growing these discolored leaves. So when we come to make changes, we say, what is it that is driving me? What is it that is making me do and say what I do and I say? And if we look at the root, if we go to the essence of who we are, that which drives us is our ratzon. That which drives us is our desire. And when we look at what is our desire, and we ask ourselves in a quiet space, a time of contemplation, what is it that I really want? And at first, what might pop into your minds is what I want, so it's physical things which I feel that I'm lacking. And if you peel away a layer and you go even deeper and you say, what is it that I really want? It might be some emotional work, relationships that need to be rectified, connections that you want to make. What is it that I really want? Maybe it's the improvements that you want to make in your character. But what is it that I really want at the essence of my being? At the core of who I am is a ratzon, is a desire to do the will of God. When we talk about doing the will of God, it's not that I have to nullify myself to do the will of God. At the essence of my being, who I naturally am, I naturally desire to do the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And we peel away all those layers until we get to the core of our being. And then we say, what is it? What is it that is covering over this natural desire of mine? What subconscious beliefs do I have that is not allowing me to access my natural desire? What external desires do I have that is covering over this natural desire? And we start to peel away the layers. And every day when we say Mizmor LeDavid, we focus on the precious words of David HaMelech. And David HaMelech expressed to HaKadosh Baruch Hu what it is that he desired. And what he said is, Achat Sha'alti Me'et Hashem. Hashem, all I ask from you is one thing. All I have is one desire. What is my desire? Shifti Ve'Veit Hashem. All I want is to be in your presence. Ribono shel Olam, wherever I am, David HaMelech said, his soul yearned and longed to be with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to feel his presence. And these holy words of David HaMelech are a tremendous lesson for us. Because in Mizmor 30, it says, Mizmor Shir Chanukat HaBayit LeDavid, when we talk about the inauguration of the Beit HaMikdash, and over there we see that the inauguration is attributed to David HaMelech, and yet we know that it wasn't David HaMelech who built the Beit HaMikdash. Shlomo HaMelech built the Beit HaMikdash. But we live in such a goal-orientated world where we measure success by the output that we are able to do, which means if I manage to do that chesed, if I manage to daven with kavona, then I'm successful. If I manage to hold myself back from speaking Lashon Hara or getting angry, that is success. But the lesson that David HaMelech teaches us is that he yearned and longed to build the Beis HaMikdash, that it's attributed to him. Because even though in this physical world he didn't succeed in building the Beit HaMikdash, he built the spiritual edifice. And when we yearn and long to do God's will, we might not be able to see the results in this world, but we have to know that in Shamayim, in the spiritual world, we are building spiritual edifices. So we follow in the footsteps of David HaMelech, and we start with that real yearning, the longing, the desire, just the wanting to serve Hashem, the wanting to be righteous. Let me read you these beautiful words of Rav Kook from Orot HaTshuva, where he says, it's impossible to imagine or measure the great pleasure that a person must feel within himself, along with the great satisfaction from within the gentle ache, which pains him at the time when the pure and holy spirit of Tshuva rests upon him. At the time when he proceeds and soars in thoughts that are burning with the fire of utter regret regarding all of his sins, misdeeds, and iniquities, we take a look at our year. We take a look at where we have been and where we have come to. Those things that are positive and those things that need improvement. And the things that improvement cause an ache in our neshama. We missed the mark. We so much wanted to be close to you, Hashem, and we lost that opportunity. And he says at the time when his soul lovingly embraces the glory of holiness and completion, her beloved, her creator, her maker, the maker of all, blessed be he. At the time when he desires with all of his heart and with all of his soul, with the deepest depth of awesome yearning to go in a simple and straight way, to become a tzaddik and to perform righteousness, to be straight and to walk in the proper path, even though it is undecided how he will remove his feet from the filth of his sins, even though yet he completely unclear how he will manage to rectify the past, even though the practical pathways are not yet cleared before him and are plattered with large stones, the desire to be good. This is the spirit of Gan Eden, which is fiery Gehinom of his deep pain, is transformed into a stream of pleasantness. And this is the teaching, the deep teaching of Rav Kook. That yearning, that desire is an avoida in and of itself. And the process of tshuva, of return, and of returning to ourselves, to the essence of who we are, means returning to that natural desire and that yearning and longing to serve God. And that alone gives HaKadosh Baruch Hu so much nachas. That gives him so much simcha. That alone is an avoida. So Be'ezus Hashem, we should all be blessed with a real yearning and longing, with that inner desire to serve our Creator. And we should see as well the fruit of our labor, but to know that even when we don't see the manifestation of that which we want, that pure yearning is precious in and of itself.